Disinformation and Public Representations of Identity, a feminist close reading of Margaret Atwood's Alias Grace. Authors, Adelina Sánchez-Espinosa and Sara Calvo de Mora Mármol from the University of Granada. The next slide includes the abstract of the article. For more information, please visit the journal ReiDoCrea. Abstract. Disinformation and fake news have always been a part of our society. Since the beginning, they have traced a media craze path, and they are blooming nowadays due to the power of the media. Public opinion can deform a story and influence one's identity performance. Alias Grace by Margaret Atwood presents Grace Marks, who is influenced by conflictive opinions which eventually determine the performance of her identity. Objective? Just because a thing has been written down, sir, does not mean it's God's truth. Margaret Atwood in Alias Grace. Our objective is the exploration of a 19th century young woman's control of her identity over the public constructions of her image, using the novel Alias Grace as our case study. Methodology. In this article, we have carried out an overall analysis of Alias Grace, applying our feminist critical tools of choice, as well as an analysis of a representative fragment that illustrates this article's thesis. We have used Feminist Close Reading by Jasmina Lukić and Adelina Sánchez-Espinosa, which is a feminist tool to establish connections between literary structures and the social context in which they were produced, including aspects such as gender, race, and class. We have also used Feminist Revision of History by Adrienne Rich. It is a break from the past to help women's liberation from patriarchal notions of history. Discussion. Is being aware of public opinion enough to grant Grace control over the self-construction of her image? Post-truths and Trumpism, such as alternative facts, have repercussions and a strong social influence. However, they could be partially challenged by taking critical approaches toward texts and the media. Conclusions. The influence of the media over Grace's identity construction and performance could be extrapolated to other women, both to Grace's contemporaries and to modern women nowadays. The analysis in this article is an illustration of how texts could be dissected to uncover the potential of literature as a transformative technology in our society. Students should be able and encouraged to take a step back and critically look at texts. To do this, close readings and historical revisions are essential tools to be used in the classroom. Thank you for listening. This article is available at ReiDoCrea, a research journal from the University of Granada.